This is going to be such a fun round. I'm so excited. Gemini, Cell, Gamachi, Pi, Lino, Zombie Grubby, Lethal, SW Pro. This is going to be awesome. All right, I think Lino is the only one who's not ready yet. Lino, let me know when ready. And then we go. Beast of the Hill, round four. We have two more rounds after this. We obviously have a couple of good guys signing up. I think the next two, we just fill it up with as many players who have not played yet as possible. If we lack players, we can obviously invite somebody else that has played before. Love to give Foxer another shotty. I think 7 of 8 are ready. Lino Jenkins is what Zombie Grub is spamming in the chat. I think this is going to be a great round. Last round was good. Ilias. What a grinder. Kept on trying. Everybody turned on him. But he did a great job in just staying alive somehow, someway. Getting a few more adepts out. And in the end, it's the 66 adepts that got the job done. 33 couldn't cut it. But 66 apparently was enough. Zombie Grub has no chance. They all go for her. Nah, everybody loves ZG. Go, go. Everyone. Go. Lino ready. Gemini ready. I'm just double checking because whenever one goes AFK, everybody else goes AFK. All right, it's happening. The gamers are good to go. The map is Darkside. I don't think I know this map. It is funny, it happens so often that everybody thinks they have turned on someone, but some of these guys do a really good job and then just running circles until everybody gets bored and they give up and they get distracted and they focus on something else. And I think Ilias did a great job in just avoiding all that trouble when everybody was turning on him. Just walked around, at one point was down to like, what, 2 adepts? But eventually rebuilt a little and got back up to all the adepts. And it was good enough. Alright guys, round 4, 75 buckies for the winner.
Round 4, fight!
2 more rounds after this, make sure to show some love to Basilisk if you can, if you've been enjoying this night, !Basilisk or !Basilisk Discord, it goes a long way. Let them know that you enjoy this kind of community stuff, it makes a big difference. Bottom side of the map, I believe our old man from Israel often brags a little about how he's one of the best older gamers out there. I think he's in his 40s. It is SW Pro. Left side, we are looking at the main base of our man from Slovakia, a proper passion lord in the European scene. I don't think he plays a lot of StarCraft anymore, but he wanted to give this beast of the hill a shot. It is Kamachi. Top left side, we are looking at the main base of Psystorm Gaming's very own Upper 3, my pal Cell. Is he the favorite here? That I don't know. What the hell is this? Lethal. Oh my goodness, opening up the forge. Next to Cell, we've got our American Protoss, who's been living in Korea. IGSL, Kodas Caster. It is Gemini. Top right side, the man who did win a Beast of the Hill last week, but that was bonus content. There wasn't any money on the line for that one. But he did win his moderation badge in my channel. It is Pi. And a great victory. Won 3 points in a row past 20 minutes to clutch up that W. On the right side, one of my favorites, a good friend of mine. It is my German passion lord and great community member, Lino. Below Lino, we've got Lethal, who doesn't know what he's doing. Never does. Opening up with a cannon in his mineral line, sure. In the bottom right side, we've got everyone's favorite American caster. It is a Zombie Grubby. So the middle is always revealed, by the way. That's the one thing I did not say yet. But it doesn't matter if you have any units in the center or not. Everyone can always see the middle. So the point is revealed and the little area around the point is revealed too. We have 2 Zergies. Actually, it seems like a nice mix, right? 3, 4 Protoss. No, 4, 2, 2 is not too bad. 4, 2, 2 is not too bad. I don't know how I would put my points on, by the way. Obviously, Pi has put in some work. Cool Zelnaga Watchtower in the water. I've never seen this. I like it. Lethal controlling the center of the map for some bonus resources. The thing is that he's gonna have a hard time spending all his money anyway. We can take a look at the income right now. You get some solid bonus income for the middle. I believe it's 10 minerals per second that you get extra. But it's not crazy. It's decent, but it's not crazy. I got myself a drink for this one, guys. It's been a long day. I've been live for 8 hours and 46 minutes. Obviously, we're going to continue tomorrow morning early within the second day of the WTL Codas playoffs. Tomorrow night, I'll also be racing with my friends. We're going to do the Monza Grand Prix because I can't do it on Sunday. Sunday, I'll be distracted by Basilisk winning it all. I'm sure you guys understand. So no racing on Sunday. But instead, we're going to play We Are the Champions by Queen. Just got to beat that Liquid Clam guy. That's doable, right, guys? Letho loses his probe. Gemini is the first one with a couple of adepts in the center. Who the hell is a Fleet Beacon already? It is Letho. He's going to build Void Race. What is this? A new probe. For more cannons and batteries. This is definitely a strategy, guys. Gamachi is the one building a spire. He's got a solid 3-base setup. Alright, fair enough. SW Pro has taken a look at Templar. And he said, alright, Sentries and Immortals is the way to go. 20 seconds until the first point gets given out. Zombie Grub is going to try to take control of the center. Honestly, pretty decent army. Do we have Steam? It's close to finishing up. I think Zombie Grub can just kill this. Yeah, so he can kill the batteries. He can go for the cannons. Letho, it's time to give up, mate. The Adepts of Gemini are here. 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second. I think Zombie Grub wins this. But there are more Adepts showing up. SW Pro is going to try to come in with his Immortal. The Immortal is gunning down the Marauders. Who gets the first point? I think it's SW Pro, right? The Immortal just lives forever. That Immortal should live up to its name. What a great move to come in with that Prism. A Zealot, a Sentry, and an Immortal is good enough for SW Pro to get the first point on the board. Ah, solid moment to show up. But this also means that everybody can see that you are the first one with a point. And that does put you under a scoop. Spoiler alert, Zombie Grub wins. I hope you're right, mate. I'd be very happy with a Zombie Grub win. Even if I love everyone in this lobby, all 8 people are incredibly awesome. But I would be very happy with a Zombie Grub win. SW Pro is going to end up losing these units to the Mutalisk of Komachi. If Komachi starts harassing SW Pro, he's going to have such a difficult time, by the way, in dealing with Mutas. Double Robo, last time I checked, not great against Spire play. What is my boy Lino doing? He's got a Phoenix. He's building some Tempest. A mixture between Phoenix and Tempest. Got a lot of Phoenix apparently. 7 of them in total. I love how Lino and Letho are next to each other. 2 minutes and 20 seconds. What is our boy Cell up to, guys? So it's just... Oh, a Battle Cruiser. Okay. Won't be C out. Look at Cell with his little corner base and all his starports. He's a Sterling. Watching out the one who's in control of the center. And there are no invisible units. He could have stayed there. He's apparently not want to stay there. Gemini has taken out a base of Phi. Zombie Grub is now going to attack SW Pros. He said, you backstab me in the center of the map. I'm going to go for you instead. Marines and Marauders stim up this ramp as they're going to take out these Immortals. And SW Pro is in a bit of trouble immediately. I don't think Zombie Grub will kill him. But he's probably just going to do enough damage to slow him down for a very long time. Tommy Grubb says Lino Tempest, boo. He tried on a scan or what? How does he know? So it'll be the Zelnaga Watchtower, maybe? I love it, LV Sim. I DM'd Lembo immediately and I was like, yo, sick match, because Lembo is a Bayern Munich fan. It's gonna be tough, but a couple of amazing games to look forward to. Playing Man City and Bayern Munich is pretty awesome. I hope that I have the opportunity to go to one of the games. I'm only sad that we don't get to play Aston Villa. That is the one match that I really hope for. Bayer Leverkusen is an amazing match as well. But very exciting. Gemini has already taken out one base of Pi. He's now going to take out another base of Pi. Does Pi have Burrow, by the way? It feels that quick Burrow is very useful to have in games like this. Zombie Grub really has it out for SW Pro. Or she just has it out for her neighbor. As Letho is going to try to battle Lino. Oh, Lino, you need to move your Tempest, mate. If carriers are on top of your Tempest, Tempest will die real quick. And again, it is a lot of Tempest. It's battery overcharge. I guess Lino barely wins this fight. Honestly, the equivalent of two monkeys hugging over a football.
I've got it. You've got it.
No one scores a touchdown in the end. Wait, Camacho just won the second point, by the way. That was apparently a point up for grabs. Nobody was there in time. It was Komachi with a couple of Mutalisk and a couple of Zerglings. And Zombie Grub is still busy killing SW Pro. So 1 point on the board for the man from Slovakia. And a lot of money in the bank. It's gotten personal between the two boys on the right side. Pi is getting pissed at Gemini. I mean, Pi, you can be angry that he's attacking you. That's kind of the purpose of the game. Oh, look at Gemini with even a War Prism in the main base. Oh no, poor Pi. Oh, Pi has got a perfectly fine army, by the way. On creep, couple of Novas fly forward. Novas connect a little bit. The Ultras are melting. Do they even have Kindness Flooding? Yes, they do, but I guess it's just not good enough. Pi is taking a serious beating. This very awkward PvP fight on the right side of the map is still happening as well. Yes, this is the scoreboard. Everybody sees the scoreboard. In my observer mode, it's not always visible. But obviously, it is my job to tell you guys who is where. I'm very surprised that SW Pro has not asked for mercy, by the way. Zombie Grub is cold. Woo! Zombie Grub is cold. Meanwhile, Cell... it thinks that this is a regular 1v1 on the NA ladder and he's playing one of his TVTs. Or it's a TVT round 1 American Weekly and Roddy is casting. Excel, it's okay to move out, mate. You're allowed to battle. Cell's low-key cooking. Because everybody else is slowing each other down. Somehow nobody is bothering Komachi, and absolutely nobody is bothering Upper 3. 50 seconds for the next point. Lino and Letho are still having a really personal battle on the right side. I'm incredibly intrigued by this fight. As Spy now wants his revenge on Gemini. Look at this. Cell is going to show up with only Marines. That's really smart, because that makes nobody think about the fact that he's got a whole bunch of BCs in the top left side. Seems like Lino is winning the battle versus Letho, guys. 20 seconds to go. Zombie Grub's got a pretty sick army to potentially get a point. 10 seconds to go. I don't know who ZG is talking to. Maybe SW Pro? Komachi tries to get the point. Banelings coming in, but I think Zombie Grub has it. No, it's Komachi and his Banelings. That's the second point already, guys. That is the second point already for Komachi. Obviously, Cell could just use his battlecruisers and actually start killing him. Is this Cell scanning? No. Lino's still busy killing Letho. I mean, to be fair, it was Letho who started this. Yes, there were some banelings that took it. I mean, Kimochi is kind of cooking. Kimochi has an army that could actually take the center. Upper 3 is making a very, very, very big mistake if he does not start attacking Kimochi right now. It's like nobody is keeping track of the scores. I mean, he should know the rules, right? Okay. He knows the rules. So I was cooking. Just double checking. Cell says he knows the rules. He's got 35 marines, 4 tanks, and 11 BCs. He is going to attack Kimochi. I think Zombie Grub picked Aaron. I mean, Kimochi could just win, man. Zombie Grub is the only one who is aware of the fact that Kimochi can just straight up win this game. We are 1 minute and 20 seconds away. As Lino is still having a good old time killing Leto, but he too should start worrying about something else, and that something else is the center. Lino is now wondering where Kimochi is. Kimochi says he's nowhere. Zombie Grub does not quite see the army. No one knows where the army is. I'm still getting angry at Gemini. 50 seconds to go. Baneling Ultra could do it. Baneling Ultra could absolutely do it here. I do think that Kimochi only has one shot. One shot and one shot only. Zombie Grub says, Jesus, scoreboard. Oh, here come the BCs of Cell. 20 seconds to go. That's very early. That is very early. I think Kimochi should go for it. I think he can win. Cell only has Marines. Go, Kimochi, go. If you go right now, you win. Kimochi, don't go. Kimochi, go. 7, 6, Ultra Bailing for the win. Kimochi wins. Kimochi must always win this. Oh, my God. Cell says, yes, I know the rules. Apparently, he doesn't. It is Kimochi against all odds. Oh my goodness. Oh my, Kimochi, mate. Congratulations. That is fantastic. That is fantastic. That is not what I expected, but I love it. Oh. And our first Zerg champ as well. After nothing but Protoss winners last week and this week, it is Kimochi who wins it. Let's go, Kimochi. Congrats, mate. 75 buckies. Go Kimochi's way. That is amazing. All right. We're going back to Europe for round 5. I know, ZG. I know. All right. I wonder how many of you guys voted for Kimochi. I highly doubt anybody went for Kimochi. A big underdog coming into round 4. What a man. What a win. 1%. 2 believers out there, and they won it all. You did, Hillmaze. You did. Choose outcome. Kimochi. What a payout, guys. Hillmaze and Ibra. Ibra, big payday, mate. Big payday. Oh my, that was fun. All right, 5th round. So Ilias obviously deserves a chance to defend his title from round 3. Kimochi, if you want, you can also defend your title, but obviously it's going to be against a whole bunch of ultra good players. But it's up to you, Kimochi. If you want to try to make the impossible possible and go back to back, you are allowed. So we at least have Ilias defending, and now Kimochi can give it a shot too if he wants to. But you absolutely don't have to. You're fine with one game, so you don't want to defend? I mean, let's go out on a bang, right? Alright. So Kimochi is fine. Ilias is going to defend his title from round 3. Do they still do Monday point games? With Monday point games? I guess you mean the ESL Weekly. There will be Monday Night StarCraft. It is not called the ESL Weekly, but there will be a tournament. ran by Statfest and me or the community or Basilisk, we will run a tournament on the Monday night. You guys don't have to panic over Monday nights. We're not just going to let the Monday night die. All right, so Fjont is in. I think Sabadas is in. If Spots wants to play, he can play Iba. Let's do Iba, guys. Iba wants to play. Let's do it. Let's make it a stacked lobby. Bunch of 6k plus MMR nerds. Spots wants to play. Let's do it. Spots can play too. And Maxim wants to play. Let's do Maxim. I think Maxim is kind of good. He can hang with the big boys, right? And then we need to maybe pick someone specifically. I'm just going to go fill up this lobby first. Then we'll run some ads. Then we're going to hop into round 5. Finally, a non-Protoss champ. And it is Camachi. 1 point every 3 minutes is too often. First point is available at minute 5. The second one at minute 9. And then it is 3 points every single minute. I mean, with 8 players, normally it should not be too much. Yeah, but everybody just didn't buy win last time. That was a bonus match. That was not official. He did win. He won the Roddy moderator badge, the mod button, but he did not win an official round. Last week we had 4 rounds and all 4 were won by Protoss. At least we can win one thing, guys. All right, who else do we have? We've got Iba, Fion. I think we need some Terrence. All right. We need some high level Terrence. Moja, but both Moja and Nihad have already played. I asked to play, but can I play in game 6? Sure. Ibra says I'm high diamond, Terran. Yeah, of course. Alright, we need to rehost, apparently. We hosted the wrong version, that's fine. You're eating right now. That's fine, mate. You can play round 6. So we have a couple people that really want to play, but have all already played. I would love to see if I can find a Terran that has not played yet today. Oh, Rikas would be welcome. I will explain the rules once we load into game 5 against KJ. I've already done it quite a few times. Soda Vlad. You sure about it, Soda? You can if you want to. What about Cuckoo? I don't think he's here. I think Cuckoo is just waiting for Battle Aces. I think that's where Cuckoo's passion is at. Alright, so we have Ilias, defending champ. We have Fjont from Sweden, Seb from the Czech Republic, Iba from the UK, Maxim, I think Germany, but I'm not sure. Spots from Germany. We need 2 players. We need 2 players. Alright. Anyone, Terran, that hasn't played yet? Alright, if Unlucky wants to play, let's invite Unlucky. He is an underdog, but that's okay. Underdog stories are awesome. Moja got very close. So. Moja, round 2. Go, go. I think Moja's second opportunity is fine. No, second chance. Azura can play next, but Azura wants to play Protoss, I think. Alright, guys. We'll give Moja another shot, because we are in dire need of a Terran in this lobby. And Moja did make that previous round very awesome. We want ZG back. I would definitely give ZG another opportunity. I don't think anybody would be upset over that. If ZG wants to play in the final round, we can absolutely do that. Okay. Full lobby. Okay, 3 minutes, then we go. All right, guys, we have a full lobby. It's a sick one. I'm actually very excited over this. Let me go ahead and start a prediction. Round 5, Basilisk, Beast of the Hill. 75 buckies for the win. It is a Fjont, SweeZ, Sabadas, Czech Republic, P. We have Moja, German, T. We have Spots, German, P. We have Maxim P, then we had, who was the other one? Unlucky T, I'm forgetting 2. Ilias, obviously, our defending champ, and Iba. Iba, UKZ, and Ilias, FFA Pro. This is it. You guys get 10 minutes. I'm going to take a tiny break. Next round starts in 3 minutes. I'll see you guys real soon. 75 buckies on the line for the fifth time. After that, we'll do one final bonus round. What a night. What a day. What a night.